Well, it is time now for what is on Rob's radar. And as Hurricane Week continues on NBC2, this afternoon I wanted to pause for a moment and talk about why it's so important that you focus on the weather in Africa. Because as you know, the weather in Africa can oftentimes impact us here in Florida by the development of tropical storms and hurricanes. But how do these tropical waves that we talk about so much over Africa form? Well, it deals in part with a lot of the collision of winds that happen this time of year. Hot and dry winds from North Africa are oftentimes colliding with west and southwest humid winds that arrive with the West African Monsoon. That generates clusters of thunderstorms that form over Western Africa, and because of the prevailing winds in the atmosphere, start to move west, eventually hitting the warm waters of the Atlantic Ocean. Now, you can step inside a new NBC2 animation to visualize what this process looks like when these tropical waves move off of Western Africa. Pretend that we build to something similar to like a big bathtub, all right? So this is our pretend Atlantic Ocean. Now, these showers and thunderstorms that work off of Western Africa, the prevailing winds, as you see with these flags, push them in your direction toward North America. We're talking about showers and thunderstorms here, so it involves rising air. As air rises, it cools and condenses into showers and downpours and thunderstorms. This condensation and evaporation process triggers the release of latent heat, which can fuel big downpours and thunderstorms that become tropical storms and hurricanes. Now, if there's no roadblocks in the form of wind shear or dry air out ahead of our tropical storm or hurricane, these prevailing winds you see can sometimes push them thousands and thousands of miles, moving from the west coast of Africa all the way to North America.